Thank you so much. Same to you. Let me try and get all this back.
We're gonna get a Lion King popcorn bucket.
Okay, Dash. Thank you.
Can I get a Lion King popcorn bucket?
Wow, that was strong. That was 2023.
Yay! Thank you. Thank you, Sam. Lion, lion, lion. Lion, lion, lion. Yes! Here we go!
Watch how it goes.
Thank you!
Lion King, Lion King.
Woo!
Lion King, Lion King.
I got it.
Thank you.
So good.
Yay, let's go ride Kilimanjaro Safari. Woo!
Or for the next week. Who knows? We might get lost. I tend to do that sometimes. But before we head in there, I have a couple quick safety reminders. Please remain seated and keep your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the truck at all times. Please keep your face covering on over your nose and mouth at all times as well. If you happen to drop anything outside of the truck, I cannot stop to retrieve it. I'll have to call the warden to come and get it for you, so hold on tight to those belongings. If you're taking pictures, I do suggest you have your camera phones or your cameras out and ready. There's lots of animals out there and I can't always stop for every single one, and they certainly do not stop for me, so it's best to be prepared to get that perfect picture. Lastly, this is the animal's home and we don't want to disturb them, so please refrain from making any noises at the animals or yelling or anything like that, because they do get scared pretty easily and we don't want to do that. But with that being said, our first stop today is going to be the Little Ituri Forest. The first animal I see is coming up ahead there on your right. That's the okapi. The okapi is very shy and reclusive. And a lot of people think it's related to the zebra because of the stripes on its legs, but it's not. It's actually the closest living relative to the giraffe. We know the okapi and the giraffe are related because they have very similar facial structures. If you put them side by side, they look almost identical in the face. The okapi actually wasn't discovered by Western civilization until about 1901, fairly recently. On the left is a black rhino. The black rhino can get up to 3,000 pounds, and it has no natural predators. But its biggest threat is humans because it's poached for its horns, which are made out of keratin. The same stuff our fingernails and hair are made out of. And there is another black rhino up here on the left, but on the right, this big black and white bird there. That is a saddle-billed stork. The saddle-billed stork can grow up to 5 feet tall, and it has a 9-foot wingspan. That's about as wide as the canopy over your head right now. It's a pretty big bird. Also coming up on your right, they're kind of hidden, they're all the way on the top of the hill here. That is the bongo. The bongo is also known as the ghost of the forest because it's very good at hiding. Their large horns lean back, which allows them to get through thick and tangled underbrush much easier. An easy way to tell the males apart from the females is by looking at their necks. The males have much darker necks than the females do. Down here on your left, I see a couple of greater kudu. I see two of them, and they're both female. I know that because only the males have horns. The females stay in packs of about 3 to 10, while the males stay by themselves most of the time. Alrighty, folks, it looks like we're now heading out of the forest and into the Sapi River. On the right is the Nile hippopotamus. When they're born, they weigh about 85 pounds. It's also one of the most dangerous animals in Africa because it's territorial.
How does it come here?
They spend most of their day submerged in the water to keep out of the heat, and then they come out of the water at night, which is when they're most active. See if there's any other hippos around here. Not seeing any hippos just yet, but what I do see is the pink-backed pelicans, these big white birds on the left. They get their name because of the coloration of their skin during mating season. And they also have a wingspan of about 7 to 9 feet.
Hippo inside the water.
Maybe.
I don't think I'm seeing any more hippos around here, but down here on the left is the Nile crocodile.
Oh, crocodile.
The average Nile crocodile is about 16 feet long and weighs 500 pounds. They also consume about half their body weight per meal. So on average, they'll eat about 250 pounds of food per meal. That is quite a bit of food. I did see some down there with their mouths open. That's how they regulate their body temperature. Since they don't sweat, they have to let all their heat out through their mouths. They're also very gentle with their eggs, and they keep their eggs in their mouth and move them around between their teeth, and that helps the hatching process. Both the males and the females do that. Coming up here on your right is the baobab tree, also known as the upside down tree because it just looks like it took it straight out of the ground and stuck its roots out. It's leafless for about 9 months out of the year, and it can store water in its trunk for the drought. The water stored in its trunk can be consumed by animals who are migrating or who are just thirsty and can't find water anywhere else. That gives it its second nickname, the Tree of Life. The really big tree you saw when you first came into the park today is also called the Tree of Life. And if you look closely, you'll see that it's a baobab tree with leaves. There's also over 300 different animals carved into it. It's pretty cool. We're now entering the African savanna. The first animal I see here with the really big horns on your right is the Ankole cattle. The Ankole cattle is the only domesticated animal on the reserve, and their horns can grow up to 6 feet long. They use them as a cooling mechanism, letting blood flow through and that's out of the excess body. The inside of the horns look kind of like a honeycomb structure with veins running all throughout. They may look really big and heavy, but they're actually pretty hollow. And the Ankole cattle is also known as the Watusi cattle because of the Watusi tribe that first domesticated them. Over on your left, if you look inside this cave here, you'll see the African wild dog. The African wild dog is also known as the painted dog because of the pattern on its fur. They're the most successful hunters in the wild, catching about 90% of the prey they hunt. And the way they catch their prey is by chasing until it passes out from exhaustion. They can run very, very long distances without getting tired. A common misconception about them is that they're related to hyenas, But actually not. That's a completely different species. These are more related to the dogs that we know and have in our homes. Over on the left there is the sable antelope. That's the symbol of the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. They're pretty tough. They go head to head with lions. They are not scared of predators at all. And their horns are pretty sharp and they lean far back. And that helps prevent animals from attacking them from behind. There's also some wildebeest here, but really quick, I'll talk about these zebras on the left. Look at this baby zebra here. This baby zebra was just born a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, a couple weeks.
These are Hartman's Mountain zebras, and I know that because of their stripes. Their stripes are thicker in the back and get thinner as they move forward. No two zebras have the same stripe pattern because they're all unique, just like our fingerprints. And if you're wondering whether they're black with white stripes or white with black stripes, they're black with white stripes. We know this because their muzzle is black, making their base color black. And the wildebeest we saw back there, they have one of the largest migration patterns on Earth. 1.5 million to 2 million of them migrate every single year. They learn how to walk and run within the first 15 minutes of life, mainly because there's always predators after them, so they have to learn how to get away fairly quickly. But if one wildebeest is slowing down the herd, they do have to leave it behind, so it has to learn to adapt. The Maasai giraffe coming up on the right. There they are.
Oh my God, zebra!
The Maasai giraffe is the tallest land animal on Earth. They can grow anywhere from 18 to 20 feet tall. And in fact, they're so tall that when the babies are born, they drop 6 feet straight down to the ground.
Ouch.
They learn how to walk and run within the first hour of life. And they sleep standing up most of the time, mainly to get away from predators quickly if they need to. Right here on the left, if you see these little guys laying in the grass there, that is the springbok. The springbok gets its name because it can spring 6 feet high and 13 feet forward in a single leap. They're also in the top 10 fastest land animals on Earth, running about 50 to 60 miles an hour. They're about as fast as a cheetah, which makes them very hard to catch.
Oh, look, I'm
a giraffe. This one's a little easier to see. On your right. So they sleep standing up most of the time, mainly to get away from predators quickly if they need to. They only sleep about 30 minutes a day, and they eat for about 20 hours a day. Sounds like a good ratio to me. They also have the same number of vertebrae in their necks as humans do. We both have 7. Theirs are just a lot bigger than ours. And a couple more giraffes here on the left. A group of giraffes is actually called Tower of Giraffes. All right, let's head to the other side of West Savannah here, see what we can find. Coming up here on the left, I do see at least one mandrill. Let's see if we can catch up to him before he goes away. The mandrill is the largest monkey in the world. The males have the red and blue colors on their faces, which get brighter as they get more excited. Let's see if there's anything over on the right. Not seeing much yet. But luckily, I do have a shortcut up here that's going to take us into elephant territory. It'll take us there fairly quickly, too. It's just up here on the right. And here we go. Whoa. Never mind, it's close. Well, that's embarrassing. This has never happened to me before. Oh, look at that. A male African elephant. Oh, there's two of them back there. I know those are males because they're pretty secluded from any large groups. Elephants are very social and the mothers stay with the young, but when the males reach their teenage years, they go off on their own. Alright, but since my shortcut back there is closed, we do have to take the long way, so I just extended your vacation by about a week. And we also have to take this super old rusty bridge. It shakes quite a bit and makes a lot of noise, but I think I should be safe because I have my seatbelt on. You guys just hold on tight and don't make any sudden movements. Here we go. Hey, cool, it's cracked. There's about 3 zip ties holding it together though, so I think we're okay. Hopefully. I made it. And the back made it, let's go.
Why are we stopped again?
We made it off the bridge and into the red clay pits. And I see some tusk marks in the clay here on the right.
I want to find a chicken.
That could be a sign that we might see some more elephants around. Oh, look at that. Right here on the left.
That's a lion.
So elephants do like to eat the red clay because it provides them with nutrients. I can't stop on this road. And they're a little hard to see because of all these bushes and trees. So let's go around the corner and see if we can get a better view. So just like the elephants we saw a couple minutes ago, the ones over here are also African elephants.
Awesome!
And one way you can tell them apart from any others is by looking at their ears. Their ears are actually shaped like the continent of Africa. I don't know if that's a coincidence or not, but it's still pretty cool. They're very smart, and they know they have sensitive skin, so they use mud as a natural sunblock. They fling the mud up onto their bodies with their trunks, and that helps protect them from the harmful rays of the sun. They also have over 40,000 different muscles just in their trunks. Their trunks can bend in all sorts of crazy ways. It's pretty cool. Alright, I don't think I'm seeing any more elephants around here. But not to worry, there's still plenty more animals to see. For example, we're about to come up on the greater flamingo.
Oh.
The greater flamingo is the lightest shade of pink out of all the flamingos. And they get their color from the shrimp they eat. They are born gray, so if you see some gray or white ones in there, those are the newer ones that just haven't gotten their color yet. But they will. They just need to eat a little more shrimp. Oh, and by the way, that's an odd shape for an island. I don't think I've ever seen one shaped like that before. It looks kind of familiar, but I can't really tell what it is. Guess we'll never know. I see a mud pit coming up. That could mean we might see some rhinos around. Rhinos like to roll around in mud pits to cool off from the hot sun. And it is a pretty hot day, so they should be around. Oh, right here on the left are the white rhinos. Let's get a little closer to them. Looks like down the road we'll have a little bit of a better view here. The white rhino is actually twice as big as the black rhino we saw earlier. These can get up to 6,000 pounds. Despite their name, they're not actually white, they're more of a gray color. They get their name from the Afrikaans word bite, which means wide, because they have wide mouths. They're also pretty, they have very sensitive hearing. And they kind of bump into a lot of things while they're walking around, which is fitting, because a group of rhinos is actually called a crash. A crash of rhinos. And we do have to be very careful over here, because we're now entering cheetah territory. And cheetahs are very hard to see because they're good at blending in with their surroundings. So you have to look really, really closely if you want to try to find them. Let's see if we have any luck out here today. Okay, I already found one. It's down the road a little bit. Let me pull up right next to it. Okay, so it's going to be up here on the left, laying down all the way back. Kind of see its head popping out there.
Where am I? Where?
And that is the fastest land animal. Oh, please remain seated. Please remain seated at all times. This is a real truck. I am really driving it. And I don't want anybody falling out. Thank you. They're the fastest land animals on Earth, and they can run about 70 miles an hour. But they can only maintain that speed for a couple hundred yards. They can run the length of a football field in about 4 seconds. They also take 4 strides per second. That is very fast. They're not considered big cats like lions and tigers because they don't roar. They mainly just growl and purr like really big house cats. But please do not try to pet a cheetah like a house cat because their claws never retract. And that does not sound like a good time to me. Alright, let's go over on the other side here. Hard to see. It's laying down. If you see these big rocks all the way on the end of the left over here, they're laying down right in front of the rocks there. They're blending in pretty well because they're in the shade. And warthogs are burrowers, which means they dig these holes you see on the side of the hill, and that's where they live most of the time. They sleep with their tusks sticking out of the holes to ward off any predators, and they're in the same family as the domestic pig. There's also an ostrich up here on the right, and a couple more. Also up here on the right, these are laying down right in front of their eggs. Look at those ostrich eggs. Those eggs are pretty big, which makes sense because the ostrich is the largest bird in the world. They're also flightless, so they mainly use their wings to help them steer while they run. And they do run pretty fast, about 35 to 40 miles an hour. Each one of those eggs weighs about 3 pounds, and a full-grown human adult could stand on one, and it wouldn't even crack. They're very strong. And it looks like we are now about to enter the Gaudi Glen. Gaudi Glen is where the warden lives. That's his house right up there. It's usually pretty quiet around here. Not a lot of animals around, but the warden does like to keep one specific type of animal here at his house. And I'll tell you why in just a second. I just have to find one first. I don't see any in the front. Let's check the backyard here. Ah, there they are. All the way in this back corner of the backyard is the Nigerian dwarf goat. They are adorable. But that's not why the warden keeps them around. The warden keeps them safe here at his house, and in return they provide them with very nutritious milk. Milk which you can then sell or turn into cheese. It's very valuable here in the village. They're also good for the ecosystem around here. They eat all the bad weeds and other plants in the ground that other animals want. They can eat quite a bit because they have a double-chambered stomach very similar to that of a giraffe, which is why the giraffe and the dwarf goat both have pot bellies. Alrighty folks, as we approach the end of our safari, I just want to take a little time to talk about conservation. If you'd like to help out with Disney's conservation efforts, you could donate to the Disney Conservation Fund. $1, $5, $10, anything you want to donate, and Disney will match that donation dollar for dollar. If you'd like to help out, you could do it at any of the retail or merch shops at the park. Go up to any register and recommend. And here comes the best part, the splash zone. We made it. And we're back at base camp, just like that. It only took us about 2 weeks to get back, which isn't too bad considering my last safari took about a month. We got stuck in the mud for 3 weeks and it wasn't pretty, but at least we made it back in a timely manner this time. those 2 weeks really only felt like 21 minutes and 52 seconds. But hey, time flies by when you're having fun. And it looks like this dock up here is occupied. So let's move on to the next one. Should only take about 10 more seconds or so. Alrighty, folks. Unfortunately, this is the end of our safari. But here at Kilimanjaro Safaris, we don't like to say goodbye because that's just too sad and too final. Instead, here we like to say Kwa Harini, which means go well. And as we approach the dock, please make sure you have all of your personal belongings.
Like a popcorn bucket keychain. And in the front it has Mickey on it. And this one a Mickey hand. This one's new.
Yes, this one new one. And this one new one. I love it.
Both of them.
Cool.
On the planet, and the moons that face the sun. There's more to see than can ever be seen, more to do than can ever be done. There's far too much to take in here. To find, than can ever be found. And as I know we have, though the sapphire sky keeps great and small, on the endless front is the same.
Together, that's Mickey Mouse.
Right, Cali River journey. Woo.
Go for the light ring on the right side.
Thank you.
Oh my god.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Like my toy.
Oh, it's called a plushie.
Do you love it?
Yeah, I love this plushie.
I love it. Look how cool.
Look at this plushie I bought. This new monster King Kong plushie I got from the Everest shop. Next time we ride Everest.
Yay!
I think you guys don't know, but I actually live in Houston, Texas. I mean, if you could check out my videos, just go to my account and like see anyone, like any single one you want.
We're gonna ride the dinosaur ride!
You could also see that Noemo's video that I posted when I was at Houston. And Houston, Texas, and
let's go ride Dino.
In the pouch in front of you. Fasten your seatbelt.
Ready?
Commencing in T minus 10 seconds and counting.
This is Seeker. Listen up. We've got to get in, grab the Iguanodon, and get out before that asteroid hits. Let's roll. What are you tracking?
Styracosaurus.
Not our dino.
Warning, meteor shower in range.
Just little one.
Olioramus.
Oh my god!
Hadrosaur. Raptor.
Time to get serious. Moving signal now! Hang on! I'm tracking a big dino on the scope. Could be ours. Computer, full stop. Identify.
Carnotaurus.
Definitely not our dino. Go, go, go! Another big guy coming up. Computer, slow and identify.
Sauropod.
Still not our dino, but at least this one's a vegetarian.
Vegetarian.
Asteroid impact in 90 seconds.
We better move it.
Pterodactyl.
Incoming!
Asteroid impact in 60 seconds.
We can't stop now! Keep going, keep going!
Compsognathus.
Computer, what's happening?
Loss of traction.
Four-wheel drive, move it!
Warning,
maneuvers. Left, right, left, right. That was close. Computer, now what?
Carnotaurus.
That's it. Abort mission. Abort, abort.
Iguanodon.
Forget it. Get them out now.
I better find him before security does. Thanks for everything!
Let's go!